Welcome back. So today we're going to talk about links. Links may sound simple, but really if you think about it, without links, what would the web be, right? It wouldn't really be a web because nothing would be connected. Links help us connect to other pages of our site and or connect to other sites. So they are very important. To create links, we use the A tag pair, which we will talk about. And we use the href attribute to specify the file name or location to what is known as our target document. Now, we organize links in what we call a navigation bar. So in this video, we're going to build one. But first, we need to understand the different types of links out there. Now, every web page and other documents available on the web can be referred to using what's called a URL or a Uniform Resource Locator, also known as a web address. And that's the standard format to access stuff on the internet, right? So a URL consists of three main parts: the scheme, the server name, and the path. The scheme, this first part here, is the way the computer asks for and communicates about the requested document. So we see either HTTP for Hypertext Transfer Protocol or HTTPS, which is Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. After that, we see the server name. So in this example, spaces.imperial.edu. And then the last part is the path or the file name. We could have multiple layers, if you will, multiple steps to our path. For example, melodychronister/folder name/document. We identify that path within our link separated by these forward slashes here. Now, keep in mind, I gave an example here of the PDF. We don't have to link to other web pages. We could link to documents, and when they click on it, it just opens the document. But be very careful what type of documents you are linking to, because if it's a docx, like a Word document, they need Word installed, and not everyone has Word installed. PDF, however, is cross-platform. It has a free downloader, so be very careful the file types that you link to and the file sizes, because if they're on their phone, that uses data, folks. And if it's really large, it will take forever and probably just give up on you. Now, there are two different types of links out there. We can link to documents in two basic ways. When we enter the URL, so for example, like this here as our href, that's an absolute link. Now, relative gives only the path and file name information necessary to locate that target document. To, I guess, really understand it, we got to think about file structure, right? So let's look at this file structure up here above. We see spaces.imperial.edu, Melody Chronister folder name document. So we have our site, right? We have our spaces.imperial.edu. Now in that site, there's a folder called Melody Chronister. And in that folder, there's a folder name, whatever you want to call it. And within that folder name, there is a document.pdf. Now, depending on where the web page is that we're creating, so if I have it here, for example, web page file in here, which our index.html would be, then a relative link would still need this step and this step because of the relationship to its location here. That's the relative link here. We'll see a lot of relative pages used. That's fine. Just remember, if you start building folders and moving your web pages around, by doing so, you may have broken the link if you didn't keep that relationship in the right order. I know it sounds a little foggy right now, but trust me, you'll get it. We're going to dive in and see what that looks like now. Okay. So I have our website open again. You'll see it looks a little different. I just played with the colors a little bit. We're going to take this sidebar and turn it into a navigation bar. Let's dive in and get it started. We're going to jump into our code here. And then I'm going to come down here. And then right below the header, above the article, is where I'm going to put our navigation. So I'm going to start with the nav. Open bracket, close bracket, and then within that nav, I'm going to throw in just three sets of paragraph tags. This first one, let's just call it one, maybe I'll just say page one. Page one, page two, and page 3. And then in order to style this, I'm going to go ahead and give it a class name, class equals, and let's just put navigation. So there we go. I got that. Now, before we run it, just so you know, it would be a mess because of the styles. In fact, you know, I'll show you. It will break. It will look crazy, but then we'll fix it. I just threw it in there in the HTML, but I haven't styled anything yet. So because of the way that positioning works, of course, it's just up here on the top. It pushes this down and, oh no, what did we do, Melody, right? But that's okay. I know what we're going to do. We're going to go in here and then we are going to comment out our aside because we're going to replace our aside with our navigation. So I'm not going to just delete it right now. I'm just going to hide it like it doesn't exist by commenting it out. Do you all remember how to do that? It's the bracket, exclamation point, dash, dash. And you'll notice when you do it right, you'll see it change in color, typically green. And then at the end of my aside, I'm going to want to close that or else it will break everything else since it doesn't close my HTML document. Another dash, dash, and a bracket. And so that only the aside is green. And then I'm going to go up here to my styles. And where I had my aside paragraph styled, I'm just going to delete the aside P and replace that with my classification I just created for navigation. So that's a dot navigation. So just checking it here, navigation, navigation, beautiful. Let's save it and then let's run it. See what it looks like now. And there we go. See, I told you. I know some of you out there were like, oh my gosh, what are we going to do? We just kidnapped the styles from the aside and assigned them to our navigation. So now we have this navigation. It says page 1, page 2, page 3. Now, of course, they're not linked yet, so it's just text. So let's go in here and actually create those links. So we're going to get into here between the paragraph and the page 1. At the end of that closing bracket, we're going to create another one, and we're going to type in A space href equals, and then we're going to put in some quotes there. Now it does automatically close the A, and so I need to type in page 1 again, or copy and move it over. Regardless, make sure that your page 1 is wrapped in the A and the P. So you should see the paragraph tag, the A space href equals tag wrapped around page 1, with a closing A and a closing P. I'm going to copy this and I'm going to paste it in front, and then I'm going to copy the closing bracket and paste it at the end. One. So now let's actually throw in some links here. So for this first one, let's do an absolute link, which means the whole darn thing, right? So HTTP colon slash slash, let's just try google.com. Google.com, beautiful. For page 2, let's try a relative link. So the only file in the folder other than index.html for this project is index2.html. So we'll just go ahead and give that a shot. And then for our third one, let's just pick on another absolute here. Let's go with Yahoo this time. Yahoo! Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, the full address there with the HTTP. With relative, we just need the last part. And then the last one here. Okay, let's give this a shot. I'm going to run it. And so if we click on the first one, let's see what happens. Aha! There's Google. Awesome, right? Now let's try the second one. Oh, there we go. This was one several videos ago, right? So my index 2, very neat. And then page 3, Yahoo. So awesome. We created our first links. I think we're going to call this one a wrap, and I'll see you in the next one.